Hello, I'm going to show you how to connect to your database cloud service instance, running remotely in an Oracle Cloud Virtual Machine, or VM. To access the database in your VM, you can either have a cloud service administrator open ports, or, as we will show here, you can use Secure Shell or SSH client software to connect securely to the VM and log in to your database. Several SSH clients are freely available, including the SSH utility on Linux platforms and the putty utility on Windows platforms. In this video, we will see how to use putty to tunnel through an SSH connection to the VM hosting a database cloud service instance. And with that connection established, we will see how you can then use the putty command window and other tools like SQL Developer to do typical database tasks. First, you generate and store a private and public key pair on your local PC using a tool such as the PuttyGen key generator. Make a note of where you store the keys, as you will need this path when you create your database as a service instance. Next, when you create a database as a service instance, you provide the public key, which gets stored on the database as a service cloud server. Later, when you initiate an SSH connection, data encryption and decryption using the public and private keys allow your client and database as a service host to authenticate each other without passing the private key across the network. Before you use the PuTTY program to connect to a VM, you will need to find the IP address, SQLNet port, and SID of your database instance on your VM. And you will need access to the SSH key file that you used when you created your database instance. To find the connection information for the database instance on your VM, connect to your database cloud service console and click the name of the database instance you want to connect to. Write down the IP address, SQLNet port, and SID name. Open the PuTTY utility in your local Windows environment, and in the initial dialog, enter the IP address you just noted in the hostname field. For connection type, select SSH. In the connection category, select data, and in the auto login username, enter Oracle. In the connection category, expand SSH and select Auth. Click the Browse button to select the key file that you generated and stored on your local PC. Click Tunnels and take the local machine SQLNet port 1521 and forward it to the SQLNet port on the remote cloud VM. Click Add, scroll up, and back at Session, provide a name for the session, and click Save. When you click Open, because this is the first time you are connecting to the VM, the SSH utility prompts you to confirm the public key. Click Yes. You are in the PuTTY command window, connected to the VM as the user Oracle, and you are in the Oracle user's home directory. You can now use SQL Plus to connect to your VM's database instance. Now that you're in the database, you can perform database tasks. For example, let's simply select table name from user tables. In the PuTTY command window on your PC, we see listed the user tables on the database running in your remote VM. Now that you've tunneled into the VM using PuTTY on your local computer, you can keep the PuTTY session open and use other local tools to connect to the database using that SSH tunnel. For example, here we see a SQL Developer connection pointing to hostname localhost and port 1521, which will use the SSH tunnel to connect to the remote VM's database. Once SQL Developer connects to your database in the VM, you can use a worksheet to issue commands, such as this same select table name from user tables. At the output panel at the bottom of the SQL Developer window, we see listed the database's user tables. And that's it. You now know how to connect to the database running in your Oracle Database Cloud Service VM. Thank you for watching.